Opening up an envelope can be so magical. You know special treasures are inside. Dates written, stories that have been told, lives that have been shared. I came across a special envelope that was from 1896. It came with checks, letters, receipts, and I imagined a story. I loved it so much that I copied the originals and created them into digitals. These antique papers inspired the journal we are creating today. I wanted to pay respect to these precious papers, so I created a digital journal in the shape of an envelope that you can print and cut out. You can use this journal to document your life, or to document the pen pals and messages that you receive from your loved ones, or even letters that you write to yourself. Hi everyone, and welcome back to Amity Bloom. We're going to be creating the easiest envelope layer journal today. I have my digital envelope journal kit in front of me. All of the ephemera pieces, the labels, the papers that I want to use inside of the journal to create a layered effect. And I also have the cover, spine, and back cover of our journal, as well as some journaling paper made from vintage letters that came with the envelope. I created a digital kit that's in my shop for those of you who want to create the same exact journal, or you can use this method for the letters or envelopes that you already have on hand. This type of journal is perfect for writing letters to your future self, putting them in an envelope, writing a letter, and storing it within the pockets and pages of your layered envelope journal. If you're using the digital kit that I created, you want to print it out and cut it out so you have the cover, the spine, and the back cover, which is essentially the back of your envelope. Take your envelope journal base and you want to fold it right where the crease is. Take a bone folder to sharpen your crease, or you can take the edge of your scissors. Now you want to repeat the same process on the back, lining it up to the top, making sure everything is straight. This is how it should look at this point: your front cover, the spine of your book, and the back cover. Just by creasing in the paper, you have created yourself a spine in your book that we can then begin to fill out. You want to choose your inside paper for the lining of your journal. Cut your papers to size. I am using some papers from my shop, and you want to glue them to the front and to the back cover, leaving your spine completely bare, as we're going to be using this for the binding process. Now it's time to create the layered base that's going to be on top of our journal. I'm going to be using the receipt from 1896 that came with the envelope. This is a really special piece of ephemera. It's more than 100 years old. I want to showcase it and I want to create a layered pocket on top of my journal. So you want to repeat the same process for the cover. You want to fold right along the spine, making sure to crease the edge. Now I am using this as a layered piece on the front of my cover, but you can use this as paper on the inside. So now that you have added a spine to your piece of paper, you then want to connect both of the spines together, making sure that they fit. When I designed this, I made sure that there would be no excess paper and it meets perfectly with the size of the envelope journal. Once you have finished this step, you want to open it up and you want to add some lining and a pocket right on the bottom so that this becomes an interactive layered piece for the cover of our envelope journal. For the pocket, I'm going to be using some vintage wallpaper that I have created into a strip so that you can easily create pockets or tags. And then I'm going to use the floral paper that comes in the kit to cover up the white spaces behind the pocket, so that everything is decorated and will look really cute together. I have cut both the lining of my decorative paper as well as my pockets to the size that fits the front layered piece of my journal, but you essentially just want to make sure that the pocket matches up with the decorative paper and you want to glue it on the front and on the back. You don't want to add anything to the spine as this is going to be adhered to the spine of our envelope journal. I like to start by adhering my decorative floral paper first. If you have a sewing machine, you can definitely sew your pockets instead, but I like to use double-sided tape, especially when it's this simple, to create a pocket for our journal. And you want to repeat the same steps for the back. And there you go, you have your front and back pocket to your layered envelope journal. Now you want to add some strong adhesive to the inside part of your spine, and you're going to want to connect it to the spine of your envelope journal. just like this. And then what I like to do is I like to take my front envelope journal cover and this layered piece, and I like to both fold them down and crease right along the edge. And now our front layered pocket piece is adhered to the spine of our envelope journal. This is what the spine looks like, and this is the back. This is turning out so cute, and you can grab your tags, your photos, your ephemera, and place it in this little pocket. I just love that. This makes your front cover super interactive. You can have different little pieces of paper peeking out. We now need to focus on the papers that will be adhered to the spine, and that will become the jelly and the jam to our little envelope sandwich. I'm going to start looking through the papers and attaching them together and to basically create the pages for this journal. I also have some ephemera pieces, little bits and pieces of paper scraps that I have saved that go with the color and theme of this journal. And even this little pocket, I think I might add this inside. So it's time to play around with these papers and see what kind of pages I end up creating. So I have just finished creating all of the pages for my journal, and you'll notice they are creased right in the center. And this is because the way that we're going to connect all of our pages together is we're going to glue each individual page to our spine. So to create a page just like this one that will go inserted and glued into your spine, the process is super, super easy. Now you can use a scoreboard if you want to. What this does is it measures and lets you score perfectly your paper right where you need to for each individual page. However, you can simply fold a normal piece of paper in half, just like this. Take the base of your journal that you have already created, and I like to just fold along the crease, measuring the width of my spine. You then want to take your paper trimmer and cut along the crease, and you're left with a piece of paper that looks just like this. You have your journaling or decorating space on the side, and then you have your little strip of paper that will be adhered to your spine. You want to crease and cut your paper just like this for all of the individual papers that you will be putting in your journal. And once you have accumulated your papers, I recommend having 6 pages front and back so that it's even. You then decide where you want to glue. So you can glue about 3 of them starting this way. Then the other 3 you can turn around and glue them this way. So let me walk you through the papers that I chose. This is the printable letter that was included in the envelope digital kit. And you can see that this is a little strip of paper that we creased that will be glued into the spine. And I folded the paper. I didn't cut anything. I folded it over, backed it with some really old music paper, added some journaling paper, and then I just used some washi to kind of mix both of them together. And so this will open up just like this within my page. This is the second insert. As you can see, this is the strip of wallpaper that we're going to be gluing into the journal. I decided to create a little belly band to tuck more things in. And then on the back, I backed it with some vintage paper, and then I glued and created a little tuck spot with an envelope. And then I also have a pocket within the envelope. Since I am going to be writing letters to myself, I thought it would be cute to create an envelope and include that in there. Now for the third page, this is going to be just a normal book page. I made sure to reinforce my really fragile pages with some masking tape. You can even use washi, just so that they don't tear whenever you're going to turn it. This is some wallpaper that I have backed up with some vintage receipt, left a little strip to be glued into the spine. Now for this sheet, I wanted to show you on camera how easy it is to create pockets for these types of pages. What I like to do is take your paper, fold it and crease it so that you have that little paper piece to glue into your spine. Take some scrap paper, fold it in half, and you want to sandwich it into your decorative paper. I think I'm just going to add double-sided tape on the bottom so that I have a nice deep pocket to add my ephemera. And with this last piece, it's just some pretty scrapbook paper that I creased it, and then I folded it over, used some double-sided tape to create more pocket space. To begin adding your pages into the spine of your envelope art journal, You want to take your first page, making sure it's already ready with pockets and everything that you'd like to include. Make sure before you start gluing that it's the perfect size and will fit nicely into the spine of your journal. Once you have applied your glue, you then want to put it right into the spine. And you want to do this so that it attaches seamlessly with your front piece. Once that has been adhered, you then want to move on to the next page. Now, I like to alternate it. So I'd like to do my front page and then I like to do my back page and vice versa. This is so that it's alternated and not one side is more chunky or more filled than the other. So now with this page, I'm going to add glue to the pink part and we're going to adhere it just like we did with the first one, making sure that there's no white spaces or gaps. So now you can kind of see how we're going to continue to adhere the rest of the pages. We're going to glue one side to the left and one side to the right, and you just continue to glue your pages to the inside of your spine. This is the final piece that we're going to add into our journal. It's that strip of wallpaper, making sure to add glue right where we need to attach it to the spine. I also always like to add a little bit of glue right on the base of my spine so that it attaches really, really nicely. And that is the last page that we needed to include to finish up our journal. I decided to use one of the ephemera pieces from the envelope kit, but I created this really lovely French labels and some blank labels, and I thought it would be so cute to add it on the spine. Very similar to really old vintage books, they tend to have little labels on the spine, and I think it just makes it look a little bit more cute. You can also use your labels to decorate within your journal. I have not only the ephemera that I designed that I need to use, but I also have in this little wallpaper pocket so many different types of pieces that I have been saving for this project in mind. I can't wait to start journaling to myself, as I'm going to use this journal as a capsule, a memory capsule, where I start writing letters to myself, date them, and I tuck them in within the pockets. You can also use this for normal journaling. From your day-to-day journaling, you can put your memories in here and then just have this lovely cover of an envelope. It looks like a book, but it's really an envelope, and it's super easy to create, which is what I love about this project. I think I will film some journal with me's using this journal, showing you how I'm going to adapt it to writing letters for myself. And I think I have some really lovely ephemera ideas that I want to create as well. So I will be sharing more videos in the coming weeks as how I'm using this little journal, as well as the other mini journal that I created using one sheet of paper. So I really hope that you guys enjoy the super easy but yet really cute way to create a layered envelope journal. The sky's the limit with how you can adapt, change, and alter this little technique, and I can't wait to see what you guys end up creating. Definitely let me know if you guys liked this idea. And if you're excited or would like to see how I start using this little journal. So of course, until next time, I hope that you have an incredible day full of peace and love. Remember to take some time, create a journal for yourself, and journal to yourself, which is really important as well. Stay safe, stay well, and I will see you very, very soon. Bye-bye, and have a great day.